Welcome to our RS at Home Total Body Conditioning 20-minute session. My name is Kayla. I'll be leading you here today. Today we're going to go through a warm-up, a one work set of three movements, three times, starting with lower body, going to upper body, and then combining the two. And today we have a fun little clean and press progression set up. So you can either have a weighted body bar, or if you don't have anything of that sort, a single dumbbell or kettlebell will do, just to have holding here. And then we'll finish with some core. So yes, welcome, happy to have you, and I'm going to go ahead and get our music started here. Let's begin. Okay, so warming up here, head to toe. We're just going to start with some simple neck rolls. Open it around, loosening out from head to toe. We'll take it the other way. Letting our intention go over the shoulders. Now with that shoulder roll, we're going to take it up, back, and down. We're working our way from top to bottom here. Think about closing that chest and bringing those shoulder blades back together. Like you're taking a big stretch when you wake up in the morning. And close it out, bring it forward, separating those shoulder blades. And then bringing it to the front. Okay, next, moving it down the body to an overhead stretch. In three, two, and one, taking that to the right side, across. Letting those hips kind of stretch open, getting that all down the side body and our obliques. So, bringing the knees here, engaging that core, that is that press in the spine. For four, three, two, torso twist up next. Take a twist towards side to side, lifting up the ankle of the back foot, giving some spinal rotation in a little more for those obliques. We're going to move to knee to chest, open up those hips a little more, and four, three, two, and one, switching now side to side, grab that knee in, squeeze up, stretching out the back of the leg, those hamstrings. Alright, reverse that, take it back now. So bringing that heel to your glutes and switch, stretching down the front of that quad. Passing on that heel, trying to get that knee pointed straight down. Alright, next move, we're going to get into some strength. Starting with a side lunge. Doing those hips a little bit more, anchoring that weight down in the heel that you're leaning towards while still keeping that chest lifted. Just body weight here as we get warm, sinking nice and low, feeling that drive on the outside of that hip. Squats in four, three, two, and one. Feet in a little bit. Sinking it down and up now, trying to get a 90 degree behind those knees, sinking down with our knees and those toes, and then driving up out of the heels. Okay, so total body conditioning, we do have a bit of cardio, we're going to do some of that in the warm-up. In four, three, two, jumping jacks now. Bringing up the arms overhead, knees out wide. Just getting that heart rate up a bit before we hit. Four, four, three, two, and one. Good work. All right, let's move into our work set, starting with our body. Body bar, or your other optional weights here. Ideally having arduous thumb distance outside of thighs. RDL is our first move. So we're going to shift those hips back, getting a slight bend in the knee, and then squeeze the back of our legs to come back to standing. That bar is traveling right down in line with our legs. Like if you were ironing out your pants, pressing it down, coming just below the kneecaps, and squeezing out. Making sure you feel that pull at the back of the legs, not in that lower back. Good job, keep that hinge coming. think more about getting those glutes to the back of the room rather than how low the wall gets to your feet. Everything will follow after those hip shifts backwards in the legs, targeting those glutes and hamstrings. Go four, three, two, and one. Front squat now, so racking that weight up that collarbone. Come down here on the fingertips, setting it down and up. Feet just outside of hips, toes turned out, and knees traveling in line with those toes. So sink down nice and low as we get warm here, sinking down lower to 90 degrees. Feeling that pull in the glutes as we stand, and then bring it back down. You should be able to wiggle the toes at the bottom of this movement. That's how you make sure we're driving out of the heels and keeping all that work in the legs. Keep up there. We absorb our weight down into those feet and then come back up to standing. Four, three, two. We're going to set that bar down and come into our cardio for today, which is a burpee. Make sure your area is nice and clear. We're just going to mat back a bit. Our first row, squat. Rock the feet out, bring them in, and stand. So we'll start here as we get more and more ground. Stepping those feet out so that they're in a nice plank position. Straight line from the crown of your head down to your toes. And then walk those feet back in. If you want more, you can add a jump at the top and hop those feet out. Make sure when you do this, you're absorbing that jump back into the legs. And jumping on those heels. I like to use my arms. That kind of helps with the height. Making sure you stay nice and disciplined. Getting the glutes down. Straight back. No matter what we're doing, whether you're taking that step in or jumping in. Four. Three, two, and one. Great work. Upper body now. On first move, upright row. Thumb distance off the thighs. Bring elbows out wide. Just to shoulder height and back down. Here, our elbows are always leading the way. Those rest staying below elbows at all times. Keeping a triangle in between our shoulders, wrists, and elbows. And these upper body movements, thinking about keeping a nice solid foundation. Feet under hips, softened in knees, and tucking that pelvis in and under. Almost like you're zipping up a tight pair of pants. Squeezing everything in the core. So we're working arching in the back by using that momentum, but instead using our shoulders to upper back, wrapping that muscle around to get that weight up and back down. Work four, three, two, and one, coming into a press. So our weight flips underneath, palms to ceiling, driving up and back to collarbone. Again, important here to make sure that we're squeezing in those glutes and the core to work with arching. That weight is always staying in our peripheral vision, right out front of our forehead, rather than letting it fall back. We're keeping it out in front here. Still driving up. Still working on that vertical drive. Nice double shoulders fatiguing out now. Second shoulder exercise here today. We have cardio on deck. Keep up here. If you're feeling this at all in the lower back, take a split stance. Distribute that weight equally and keep that work in the arms. That weight coming in front. Forward to the floor. Three, two, and one. Burpees. Put that weight down. Either taking our squat and set out option or a full jump. Hop out and hop in. think about keeping a straight line. Wrists, elbows, and shoulders, and your knees down, straight line at the bottom. And on that jump, really think about driving on the heels, reach up high, and then hold at the bottom so you can go back again, making it one by one movement. Putting together our lower body and upper body now for that clean and press progression. So grab that weight, pull it up your body bar, kettlebell, or dumbbell. Both of those start off the clean first. So combining the RDL and the high pull. So go that hinge, get that hinge, and then we're going to snap that weight under. So it's the same drive as the upright row, except one more step, it goes all the way. So use the legs to pull up, and then get that real leg in. Think about driving those elbows out wide, and punching in. So from the side, you want to make sure that weight stays nice and close to our body, while we're letting it fall out in front. So that everything's through our shoulders and our back, grounding in our forearms. So a pinch, and then snap that way underneath. Shoulder those elbows out wide, so they can get underneath quickly. Four, three, two, let's add on another step. So after that clean, squat it out, and then use that squat to press the bar up, come back down. So knee, shoulder up, use those legs. Open it up and folding it down, drive up out of those fingertips, catch it, and bring it down. Functional power lifting move here. You see the Olympians doing this one. You want to get low as you drive up, because the heavier that weight is, you don't want to be bringing that too far up overhead. So that's why we're focused on dropping all of those legs as a catch, and then using that catch of the legs to drop overhead. Nice job. Keep it up. Controlling that bar. Elbows out wide. Pinch. Back of the legs. Catch and drive. Four, three, two, and one. Okay, let's finish out those burpees. Give it all you got here, last set. Then we'll back to one. Stay on the mat for the rest of the time. So we're going to let you go hop in both places. In one. And stand for taking that set out. Take the ultimate challenge you the best today. We'll finish this song out here. Keeping that set position between wrists, elbows, and shoulders. Weight in the heel as you squat down. Straight line as you're over that plank. Let's go. We've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Grab a drink. Alright, down on the mat. No weight required now. Okay. Tabletop position. Donkey kicks. Alternating side to side. Spread those fingertips out wide. So you have a nice strong foundation in those hands. Keep a bent leg. And drive that heel up to your ceiling. Turn the belly button into spine so you have a nice straight back. Our elbows and shoulders step over wrists. Keep hips, knees, or toes, bringing the knee out to the elbow. So working those obliques, bring that knee out wide. On the knees, feet on the same, feeling that work in our outer glute, quad, and in our obliques. Still keep those shoulders stacked above the wrists. Our belly button engaged by pulling it back into spine, keeping everything strong and centered. For four, three, two, and one. Super hands now all the way down on the stomach. We're going to lift up the heels and the hands and squeeze in the back of the legs. So all body weight here. Squeeze in the back, lifting them in the chest and squeeze those shoulder blades. Finishing out with these accessory movements here today. After all that powerlifting we did next week, hope you enjoyed it. See how far you can lift up. Keep that base forward. Bring the palms up as well as lifting up your legs. For four, three, two, and one. Our cardio, we're going to finish up as a commander. So make sure you don't knock over your water bottle. And then bringing it down to forearms and then up to a hand plank. So either an extended plank with those arms straight out or forearms down. Switching from right left to left right to push equally out of both hands. You can be on your knees here to kind of get that heart rate up, get that speed ready, or stay up on the toes, which makes it a little more challenging to stay still, trying to keep those hips even, and we'll go from rocking around. Four, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and ride all done. Let's stretch out. Coming into a nice seal stretch, lift through that lower back, and lift up. Great work here today. I hope you enjoyed that 20-minute workout. Alright, let's stretch those legs now. Bringing a right leg forward for a third row stretch, keeping that front shin parallel to the front end of the mat. Back leg bent or straight, and lean it forward to stretch that hip. For four, three, two, and switch legs. And hand it forward. Touching that outer glute. And leaning forward to feel a little bit more. Alright. Let's stay here in the middle. Pull that knee into chest. Good. And then cross it over. And twist. And switch. Pull that knee back. Lean to get that stretch on the back of the leg. And then cross. And twist. Lunge, stretch out those hips a bit more. Let's bring the left leg forward. Be on toes or just off the knee. Let's step in and switch. Staying straight up and down, really pushing forward. Alright, step it in. Let's take a few bear hugs here. Stretch out that upper body. Arms up and down. So one goes going backwards and forwards. Alright, torso twist. Just like we started with. We're going to let everything loose. blew it in and out. Good job, everyone. Thank you so much for joining today. My name is Kayla, and this is Total Body Conditioning. If you have any questions, please reach out. We'd love to hear from you. And that is all for today. Have a great rest of your day. And good night.